Hello and welcome to
The
The
Week
Week That
That Rocked.
Rocked. I'm news anchor Ray Halpin.
And I'm news anchor Meg Lemieux.
This week on news, we have Steph Beegan, Emily Shea, me, and Meredith Nabeskel. Have you ever volunteered a few hours a week? Do you like kids? Well, if you've answered yes to any of these questions, you should be in the Helping Hands program. As part of the program, you volunteer to basically babysit, just play around with maybe 2 to 5 year old kids for a couple hours a week, and you can help their mothers. They can just go shopping, they get to watch their soap operas, whatever they want to do. I have a tape of what you do on the Helping Hands program. I interviewed my client, and here's the tape. You can hear Adam in the background. This is part of the Helping Hands program. I volunteer a couple hours a week to come and watch, take some of the weight of the kids off Maureen's hands. I was just wondering, Maureen, what do you think of having a 17-year-old just come into your house and, take your kids for a couple of hours?
I love it. At first, I was a little nervous.
Yeah.
Trying to figure out what does a 17-year-old boy want to come in here. But it's been great with my kids, especially two boys being hyper as they are.
Yeah.
But it's been worked out good. They look forward to Ray coming every week.
And I'm trying to come more often, but so you get a chance to watch the soap operas and everything.
Yes.
Get a little time off there.
Watch the O.J. Simpson trial
Oh,
in peace. And not watch The Lion King. So that helps. Yes, it does.
Definitely. So what do you think, Ryan? Do you like me to come over here? Yeah, I think that means yeah.
Yes, that
And
means it.
And Adam, I think he says yes too.
Adam, you like Ray coming?
Yeah.
So how do you feel about the system itself, the Helping Hands program?
I think it's very good. I was telling a friend of mine about it, and they were interested in how they have three kids, but they're little. They have twins and a three-year-old girl, 2.5-year-old girl. So they were interested too. I think it's good. I think it helps. For Ryan, I think it's like having a big brother.
Yeah.
He's having the older sibling, because he usually does the running around, so now Ryan has someone to run around with him.
Yeah, that it's
so it
really
works out good.
All right, so well, I guess we'll wrap it up. And if you're thinking about joining the Helping Hands program, all you do is you just sit around, watch some kids, play around with them, like you did when you were 5 years old. That's it. Back to you.
Me. Every year, the Wakefield High School Latin Club hosts a Roman banquet, complete with Roman traditions such as games, food, and even the roasting of a pig. Here's President Steph Beegan, live from the pig.
The club's Roman banquet has become an interesting tradition. Under the leadership of Mrs. Paula Smith, the Latin Club, one of Wakefield High's largest organizations, dined on mushrooms, fruits, bread, and of course, pig. The roasting of the pig is a day-long event. At 6:30 in the morning, dedicated members came to the school to set up the spit and begin roasting the swine. One student who has been instrumental in organizing this year's banquet is co-consul Matt McDermott. Matt, thank you for joining us. How's the pig coming along?
Ah, it's coming along good.
Great to hear. Do you find that a lot of kids eat the pig?
Yeah, most of them eat it, I'd say.
What do you think your favorite part of the banquet is?
I'd say cutting the eyeballs out of the pig.
Oh, that's really nice, yeah. All right. Sounds like the Roman banquet should be fun this year. Thanks.
Oh, yeah.
The dinner is not the only part of this glorious party. Members also play games that, though not Roman, are still fun. At this Roman banquet, held on the Ides of March, students enjoyed Twister, the Limbo, and relay races. Once again, Mrs. Smith and her Romans pulled off a successful Roman banquet. Back to you, Megan and Ray.
I went in on the pig.
We gave you your food. Now we're going to give you your entertainment. Now we want to entertain you. For this, we go to Meredith Nabeskel, who will give her own rendition of E's Talk Soup. Stay tuned. She's much better than John Henson. Meredith?
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the weekly roundup entertainment segment of The Week in Rock. Time for the late night talk show review, the real reason why no one can get up for work in the morning. David Letterman last night featured guest stars such as Jon Stewart and Joe Cocker singing new tunes from his CD, and Jeff Daniels stars such movies as the fast action thriller Speed and Tears of Endearment, most recently known for the comedy Dumb and Dumb with Jim Carrey. The real question is, everyone is wondering about whether Jeff Daniels is dumb or dumber. Folks, he's dumber. You heard it here first. Anything new in the music industry? The group Soul Asylum, who hit the Billboard's top 10 list with the release of Grave Dancers Union 2 years ago, has most recently announced that with a follow-up CD in June, they will also have a new drummer, Sterling Campbell.
We replaced Carl with the black box, and he's here for the interview.
Say hi, Carl.
Carl's back in Minneapolis. Say hi, Carl.
Hi, everyone.
This is Sterling Campbell, our new drummer, one of the greatest drummers in the whole wide world. Making Grave Dancers Union, we needed a drummer, and we called up Sterling, and he showed up, and we were just spoiled to death.
Unrehearsed and ready to go, actually.
Just changed everything in all the right ways, and nothing sounded right without him.
Now for the review on the Daily Soaps. They're making lots of bubbles. Join me next week when I'll have the review on Sheryl Crow's concert March 22nd at the Orpheum, and news on MTV's Spring Break. And folks, that's all she wrote.
Before closing the show, I'd like to tell you about the National Honor Society dinner. It's going to be held Wednesday, March 29th in the cafeteria. It's going to have a 50s theme. Tickets are $5, and you can buy them from any National Honor Society student or from Miss Lind. Megan?
CSF will be holding a dance on March 24th at 7:30 in the cafeteria. The tickets are $5 and will be available during lunch. Thanks for watching. Join us next week on
The Week That Rocked.